of craving. But the derivative were also gifted of gluttony. You know what gluttony is. To eat free chicken, and you eat eight chicken. You go to the buffet, eat everything you see, till your stomach start hurting, your head start hurting, your stomach. You gotta go, you gotta go, you gotta go, you gotta go, you gotta go. Get back, I gotta go. That's gluttony. You just eat, eat, eat till you can't eat no more, can't see no more. And when you get home, you're so uncomfortable, you can't even sleep. But that's what gluttony. That's what it is. And you're so full, God will bless you with a meal, you just gonna gladden yourself out. That's what it says here. That's it. Both of the original were also gift of gluttony. Paul warns them to stay away from any food that offends their brother. The Israelites, here we go, worship idolatry and pay for it with their lives. That's a high price to pay for worship anything with God. But the Corinthians thought they could take part in idolatry without fear of reprisal for God. Now that do sound like us. Do anything we want, anytime we want, with anybody we want, and God ain't gonna do nothing to us. He loves us. I can pray and get relief. But that ain't what it says here. It says they paid for it with their lives, and they had no fear or reprisal for God. That's the Israelites. The Israelites were sexually immoral as idol worship. And the Corinthians was teaching that everything is permissible. Write this down here. That's Corinthians 6, 12. And chapter 6, verse 12. And Corinthians chapter 10, 23. We need to write that down because they were teaching everything is permissible. Everything is permissible. Do what you want, when you want, who you want, where you want, everyone you want. Don't make no difference what you want to do. Just do it till you can't do it no more. That's what they say. Everything is permissible. The Israelites assumed the question of plans and purpose of God on their trek to the promised land of Canaan. As a result, they were killed by snakes. And here were the Corinthians thinking that they knew better than God the path that would bring them to heaven. Paul chastised them, saying, "For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and will bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent." And finally, the Israelites rebelled against Moses and Aaron, God's appointed leaders, and the disciples was dead. And the discipline was dead. And that's how Christ was blessed. The discipline was death. It wasn't 15 to 20. Young man brought a baby the other day. I knew him. Who he used to date. Saw him on TV. He gonna get at least 20 robbed the bank. Then our jail says, he got a prayer in November, he's going back in February. Robbed the bank. But they ain't gonna kill him. You might wish they did. But these people, the discipline was dead. Could it be that Paul was dealing with the same thing? Some was following Paul, some Apollos, some Cephas. How do you save Christians from their own false security? How do you save us? You teach them the truth and pray they will listen. That's all you can do. Teach them the truth and pray they will listen. That's all you can do with your kids. Your kids, that's all you can do. tell them this. You can't whoop them no more. They'll call 911 on them. See, kids in the store every day, talking back to their parents.